This Mass is offered as a Thanksgiving Mass to St. Joseph, patron saint of Catholic Church, requested to offer by Sabina Xavier. For late Mary Servina Colasso, requested to offer by children. Thanksgiving to St. Joseph by John Alex and family. For late Isaac Manuel and Clara Isaac, requested to offer by Isaac family members. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
If we give a KG student the thesis of PhD and tell the student to read, he could only search for the letters of the alphabet. But surely the same student will be able to read if there is a guide or a teacher who instructs him and makes him understand, makes her understand. So Jesus is telling his disciples that whatever he was teaching, they were unable to understand, but they need a paraclete, advocate. So that's what Jesus is going to give, that paraclete or advocate who would instruct them whatever he was teaching. And this paraclete, my dear brothers and sisters, we should not understand that he is going to, or he could be an incarnate person, that he is going to start a new religion or a new way of life, or he is going to teach new things, but he would not. He would only interiorize each and every one of us the words of Jesus. And he will only ask us to meditate and meditate, and nothing he brings new. Because Psalm 48 verse 14 says, For this God is our God forever and ever. And Isaiah chapter 40 verse 8 says, the grass withers, the flowers fade, but the word of our Lord will stand forever. The words of Jesus remain same, but ever new and active. The paraclete will teach us many things, but if we only able to take him as our guide. Let us acknowledge our sins, so to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You sent. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You sent the Paraclete to teach us all things. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as we celebrate in mystery the solemnities of your Son's resurrection, so too we may be worthy to rejoice at his coming with all the saints. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
God whom I proclaim is, in fact, the one whom you already worship without knowing it. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, verses 15 to 22, 18, 1. Paul escorted him as far as Athens and went back with instructions for Silas and Timothy to rejoin Paul as soon as they could. Paul stood before the whole council of the Areopagus and made this speech. Men of Athens, I have seen for myself how extremely scrupulous you are in all religious matters, because I noticed as I strolled round admiring your sacred monuments that you had an altar inscribed to an unknown god. Well, the God whom I proclaim is, in fact, the one whom you already worship without knowing it. Since the God who made the world and everything in it is himself Lord of heaven and earth, he does not make his home in shrines made by human hands, nor is he dependent on anything that human hands can do for him, since he can never be in need of anything. On the contrary, it is he who gives everything, including life and breath, to everyone. From one single stalk, he not only created the whole human race, so that they could occupy the entire earth, but he decreed how long each nation should flourish and that all nations might seek the deity and by feeling their way towards him, succeed in finding him. Yet in fact, he is not far from any one of us, since it is in him that we live and move and exist, and indeed some of your own writers have said, we are all his children. Since we are the children of God, we have no excuse for thinking that the deity looks like anything in gold, silver or stone that has carved and designed by a man. God overlooked that sort of thing when men were ignorant, but now he is telling everyone, everywhere, that they must repent, because he has fixed a day when the whole world will be judged, and judged in righteousness, and he has appointed a man to be the judge. And God has publicly proved this by raising this man from the dead. At this mention of rising from the dead, some of them burst out laughing, Others said, "We would like to hear you talk about this again." After that, Paul left them, but there were some who attached themselves to him and became believers, among them Dionysus the Areopagite and a woman called Damaris and others besides. After this, Paul left Athens and went to Corinth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: Your glory fills all heaven and earth. Your glory fills all heaven and earth. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise Him in the heights. Praise Him, all His angels. Praise Him, all His host. Response: Your glory fills all heaven and earth. All earth kings and peoples, earth princes and rulers, young men and maidens, old men together with children. Our response: Your glory fills all heaven and earth. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for He alone is exalted. The splendor of His name reaches beyond heaven and earth. Response: Your glory fills all heaven and earth. He exalts the strength of His people. He is the praise of all His saints, of the sons of Israel, of the people to whom He comes close. Response: Your glory fills all heaven and earth. Gospel acclamation.
God has spoken to His people. Alleluia. And His first numbers of wisdom. Alleluia.
Since you have been brought back to true life with Christ, you must look for the things that are in heaven, where Christ is, sitting at God's right hand. Alleluia.
God has spoken to His people. Alleluia. And His words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 16, verses 12 onwards. Jesus said to His disciples, "I still have many things to tell you, but you cannot bear them now. When He, the Spirit of truth, comes, He will guide you into all the truth. He will not give His own message, but will speak only of what He hears, and He will declare to you the things to come. He will take what is mine and make it known to you. In doing this, He will glorify me. All that the Father has is mine. Because of this, I have just told you that the Spirit will take what is mine and make it known to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
St. Paul and his companions were in Beroea, but the people, especially the Jewish people, didn't want him to proclaim about the risen Christ and His message. They planned to harm him and his companions. The community there realized that the plot, they come to know the plot, and they try to save Paul and companions. So that's how they accompany Paul and companions separately to a place where outside the bars. Then Paul is reached as close as Athens, city of Athens now. But the other companions of his were somewhere very far. So Paul was waiting for them. Meantime, he, as we know, that Paul never kept quiet, but he always had the vigor to do something for Christ. So he went to the city and observed what we heard today in the first reading. That the Paul, till now he was speaking in an ordinary language so that the people could understand the message of Jesus Christ. Now Paul is speaking to the intellectuals, philosophers and stuck. So he is taking his language to their level and making them to understand the message of Jesus Christ. As a Christian missionaries, we need to adopt this kind of language to ourselves too, this kind of life too. Ordinary people, the message of Jesus Christ should be able to understand to the ordinary people, and as well as the same person, Jesus Christ, the message should be given to able to understand, make them understand to the high intellectual people too. This is what a missionary, a messenger of Jesus Christ should do and adopt. Now so Paul observed and told them that the reality of Jesus Christ. Till now they were worshipping to a God who is unknown to them. And Paul clearly, intellectually condemns them, shrewdly condemns them, and diverts them towards God, the creation. Here in his speech, he never mentioned about Jesus Christ, but he is taking them towards Jesus Christ. But people there interrupted. They laughed at him when they heard that Jesus, the person risen from the dead, about the resurrection. The people of those times, they did not never believe in the resurrection. That's how when Paul spoke about resurrection, people laughed at him. Did Paul stop at that? No. He continued to preach. Only because the people were going out, so he was interrupted. He was stopped. My dear brothers and sisters, today in our presence too, there are unknown golden statues. Statues made of silver. This may be our smart gadgets, whom we adore so much. We try to keep for ourselves. As St. Paul saw in that place, to an altar to an unknown God. We do have unknown altar, God, unknown altars. Tables spread for business. Tables spread for partying and pleasure. To this we give more importance than to Jesus Christ, the Word incarnate. We need to divert our attention towards Jesus Christ. The Spirit of Holy Spirit is helping us, trying to tell us, teach us about Jesus and about the way of life, about the eternal life and the true happiness we can get only in Jesus Christ. There is, as the church believes, there is an element of truth in here and there, in some other religions, some other faith, some other people. But the real faith and the ultimate fullness of faith is found only in Jesus Christ. We cannot deny that. And the real joy and the complete happiness is found only in Jesus Christ alone. And no other person, no other religion. Because he himself said, I am the way, the truth and the life. We need to be aware, make up our minds that we have to decide to follow only our Lord and Master, Savior, Jesus Christ, not an unknown God. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the
Lord. Let us give thanks to Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought us the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim:
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, giving you thanks, broke it, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving you thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thummabala, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At our Savior's command, and formed by his divine teaching, let us dare to say, Our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always be freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we celebrate the coming, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other sign of Christ.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who come to partake in the supper of the Lamb. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things,
and I desire to receive you in my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart.
I embrace you as if
you were already there,
and unite myself wholly to you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
I have chosen you from the world, says the Lord. And I have appointed you to go out and bear fruit, fruit that will last. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who are imbued with the heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is celebrated. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning, Father.
We wish you all a happy and busy day. May God bless you.